After learning how to build a simple version of a DC motor, in this video we are going to see what are the main components of a DC motor and what is the function of each. Before we get started, if you want to support us, don't forget to leave a like at this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. The DC motor we are going to disassemble is a starter motor. Well, let's start removing the nuts of the two main screws of the engine in this way. This is the hook that allows electric current to flow into the solenoid. Now, we're going to remove the screws holding the solenoid anchored to the body of the engine. The solenoid has the function of transferring the movement to the shift lever and consequently to the drive pinion. Now, we're going to remove the two main screws of our engine. Okay, now we can remove the rear cap in this way. And we also remove the front cap in this way. Inside the front cap, we can find the plunger, the return spring, and the shift lever. Now we can remove the brush end plate. In this way, we can see the four graphite brushes of our DC motor. These brushes provide high speed and torque and are responsible for transferring electricity to the copper windings of the engine. On the back of each brush, there's a spring. Each spring pushes each brush against the collector even when the brush is consuming due to its mechanical friction with the commutator. Now, we can remove the rotor from the stator in this way. The stator provides a rotating magnetic field that drives the rotating armature. It's part of the magnetic circuit together with the rotor and contains the windings. The rotor instead represents the moving components of our DC motor. Like we already noticed, building our small version of a DC motor, in the rotor are the copper windings which are immersed in a magnetic field while the electricity flows through them, allowing the rotary motion of our engine. Now we can remove the brush cover in this way. This is how our engine transfers mechanical energy to the outside. The solenoid allows the plunger and consequently the shift lever to move forwards in this way. The shift lever is hooked to the drive pinion. The drive pinion is connected with the flywheel, allowing the transmission of the motion from the engine to the outside. So, these were the main components of our DC motor. Finally, if you found this video useful, let us know by leaving a comment and subscribing to our YouTube channel to stay tuned on the release of new videos. Thanks for watching!